today we are going to discuss about the universal law of gravitation. Actually, this law of gravitation is given by the Newton. This is known as Newton's law of gravitation. But as this law is universal, now universal means this is applicable of the each and every body of the universe. That is why this law is known as universal law of gravitation. If we will consider, we can consider any two bodies of the universe, this law means one force will work between both the bodies, and this force is, we can say this force is only attractive force. So this attractive force is known as gravitational force. So this gravitational force is working on each and every object on the universe, whether object is celestial object, the object is on the earth, the terrestrial object, whatever the object can be, this gravitational force, this is working on each and every object of the universe. Second thing, not matters then the what is the shape or size of the object, whatever mass of the object, mass can be anything, shape or size can be anything. That if we will consider two objects, one is mass m1 and another is mass m2. So in such situation, whatever the masses of the body, no matters, that attractive force, this is known as gravitational force, will work in that. Whatever the distance between them, whether they are very near, they are far with each other, whatever distance they are having, no matters, that also, then in such situation also, this gravitational force will work over there. Now we can discuss how we can just describe if we will consider two objects. One is mass having mass m1, another one is having mass m2. The body is A and B. A and B body is having mass m1 and m2, because already we discussed shape and size not matters, mass is not matters, or the distance between these objects are r. So in such situation, how we can describe if we will, the first term will come, the product of their masses. The product of their masses will be directly proportional to the applied force, will be the force, this force is that gravitational force. So how I can describe, F will be directly proportional to m1, m2. The product of their masses directly proportional to the attractive force or gravitational force. Second case, this is equation number one. We can say second equation, the distance between that will be inversely proportional. Inversely proportional of which? Inversely proportional of the gravitational force. So this is equation number two. Equation number one we got, F is directly proportional to m1, m2. Second equation we got, F is inversely proportional to r square. We can describe in such terms, this is our equation number one. This is our equation number two. F is directly proportional to m1, m2. The product of the masses, F is inversely proportional to this distance, square of the distance between that. F is proportional to 1 upon r square. When we combine equation 1 and 2, we got this equation. F is proportional to m1, m2 upon r square. As we already know, whenever a proportionality sign is removing, we got a is equal to sign along with a constant. Constant, most of the time we are considering constant K. But this time, our constant will be G. This G is known as gravitational constant, or universal constant of gravitation. So this G is gravitational constant. It matters what is gravitational constant. Gravitational constant we can say in such situations, like now the term G came. What is G? G is gravitational constant. Now how we can define what is the SI unit of G? The SI unit of G we will describe, like if we will consider F is equal to G, m1 m2 upon r square. If we want to find the value of g, we will cross multiply this. So we will get f r square is equal to g m1 m2. So we will write down here f r square is equal to g m1 m2. If we want to find the value of g, we will write down g is equal to, simply g is equal to m1 m2 as denominator and f r square. The term will come, G is equal to F R square upon M1 M2. Now easily we can find the SI unit, our term was G is equal to FR square upon M1, M2. How we can find the SI unit of G? What is the SI unit of force? Force SI unit is Newton. We all know R distance, meter square. And if we will ask what is the SI unit of M, this will be kilogram, and here also kilogram. So kilogram into kilogram will be kilogram meter square. So how we can say Newton meter square per kilogram square. So what will be the SI unit of this gravitational constant? Newton meter square per kilogram square, or we can say kilogram minus 2 power. Fine. Now we can just describe in such situation when a object, when a force is working between two objects or two bodies, whatever force is applying both the one body, body A, the same force will applied by the body B, because this is a force of attraction. So here we can say F1 will equal to F2. We removed that proportionality sign like earlier we did. We got gm1 m2 upon r square. This is our formula. And now we can just understand, distance can be considered as d also, can be considered as r also. Fg is equal to force of gravitation. They have given gm1 m2 upon r square. One more problem is coming sometime. Students are becoming confused between g and g. This small g, as we know, acceleration due to gravity, and capital G, we are knowing gravitational constant. So every time whenever you will see capital G, I hope you are remembering the SI unit of small g is meter per second square, because this is acceleration due to gravity. And this g is having SI unit Newton meter square per kilogram square. This is gravitational constant, this is acceleration due to gravity. So such differences are there between G and G. G and G means small g and capital G. Now what is the value of G? Well, because it is a constant, to a specific value is also required. SI unit, you already understood, Newton meter square per kilogram square. And what is the value of G? 6.67 into 10 raised to the power minus 11. Okay, thank you very much.